Hello and welcome back to another Dome Keeper video. It's been a while since I last posted, over 8 months. It's also been a while since I last played the game. 2 weeks ago there was an update to the game, and before that there was an update, and I totally didn't play during any of it. That update added something like 11 new gadgets, it added supplements, and other things to change some overall balance to the game, to, in my opinion, make it more enjoyable. This game, I love this game, and it somehow got better. All the new gadgets and the supplements, they just add so much value to the game and how diverse it can be. I think eventually, if you're going for top scores, like I try to do, there will be probably one setup where everybody will be doing it. But we're not at that time yet, and we can do a little bit of experimentation. And that's exactly what I'm doing on this run. So this is a minor mode run. And before minor mode, the choice, let's see, the tech group choice was doing split spheres. And you wouldn't get any gadgets, you would just strictly mine. But since there's been changes in how you add to the multiplier, it makes it so getting and using gadgets is actually helpful, and that makes the gameplay just a lot more exciting. So you'll see, actually find some gadgets and use them, find some supplements and use them. But I won't be using split spheres today. I'll be using Reflex, and last time I played, I didn't need Reflect at all. I don't know if any changes were made to Reflect. I think it was buffed a little bit. Yeah, I don't know. So I tried split spheres and I tried exploding spheres in this latest update, and I couldn't get as much success with my did in this run, and this is using Reflex, you get pretty consistent results. So if you want to use the same setup that I do, what I do is first I get Reflect as the first tech group, and the gadget I get is Suit Blaster, and Suit Blaster allows me to quickly mine patches of minerals. Suit Blaster, and then I get the supplement Cascading Spheres. That works really well with Reflex. Then after that, I get the Underground Station, and I get the supplement Cartography. So you'll see, as I'm playing this through this run, I use the Underground Station to get upgrades without going to the top. And I also use it for the mini-map that it displays. And what the mini-map does is it shows everything that you've mined. It shows the whole map that you've mined. And it shows even some resources that are hidden within the unmined rock. So you can see further than you would then have that mini-map. So I use that to make a good route. And so I'm not just running back and forth and wasting time. So you'll see me in this run consult that map, and I'll just be staring at it. if you're wondering why I'm just sitting there with a map on the screen, I'm looking at it just to see what the next step is. And I'm looking at like the rock formations so I can remember to like take a left at this certain rock formation, so I don't get lost. That's what you'll see me doing quite a bit this run. Also, I've tried using other gadgets. I've used the resource converter. I've used the drilling rig. And I tried to use a mushroom farm, even getting a supplement for it. And it's probably worth trying again, I suppose. I just couldn't get anything working really at all. Then again, a lot of these things that I tried was when I first played. Was when I first played when I got the new update. So my skills have gotten better. I don't know, maybe it's worth revisiting the mushroom one. Or you could try it. Let me know how you fare. Anyways, yeah, I thought I'd just do a little commentary with this run. And at some point, I'm just gonna say goodbye and you know, watch the rest of the run. But what I'll just tell you what I really like about Cascading Spheres is having three wide tunnels. I don't know, just makes, I really enjoy that. It makes me happy. And less claustrophobic, and it's easier to navigate when it's just wide tunnels. As you can see right now, I'm bringing that supplement, and gonna give myself Cascading too. What I make sure when I have this supplement here, I make sure that I have at least 16 iron, because what I want to do is buy the second upgrade for Reflect. So when I have the 16 iron, I get that second upgrade, and that allows me to use that that upgrade. It lasts longer. The circles do, the upgrade, the Reflect circles, and also there's less of a cooldown, so I can place them faster, and that allows me to travel just fly through a tunnel, dig a tunnel really fast. I think it's really powerful with Reflect. With Split Sphere, it's not that good, because the moment you split the sphere, the cascading, that supplement, it doesn't work with those split spheres. And I understand, because that would just make split spheres very OP. Exploding spheres, I suppose you could test that out a little bit more. I found Reflect to be super fun. And as you can see, I'm digging straight down, and a lot of the times I'll dig down, and then I'll dig to the left, and I'll dig to the right. And that's how, that's the big recipe. Dig down, then dig to the left, and dig to the right. And just make sure to cover it. Yeah, so I'll be mining several patches at a time. And unfortunately right now, the game isn't 100% optimized. I heard that they changed their, or they updated the game to the latest engine of Godot. I think it went from Godot 3 from Godot 4. So I guess I'll just take a little bit of time to optimize the game to make it smooth like it was before. So I think that's about it. I don't really have anything else to say, except that, you know, it's kind of nice to be back and playing this, and I like making videos when I can. You know, it's just like a side project that I do in life. So this is an awesome game, and I really dig it. If you get the joke. Yeah. So if you have any questions about this game or this run, just let me know in the comments. And I hope you're having a good day and have a good rest of the week. Goodbye.
Thank you. Thank you.